Aloha, everybody. This is Christopher with AG Productions. Welcome back to Monster Fest 2017 and this week's edition of Mini of the Week. Today I have a very cool miniature that I'd like to show you guys, simply named Alexander. Now, Alexander is manufactured by Grebo Games, which some of you, if you've been following the channel long enough, may remember I featured during a Kickstarter update way back in February of 2016. I liked their Kickstarter miniatures so much that I made sure to continue to follow the company to make sure that those Kickstarter miniatures were produced and that the company was indeed growing, and they have definitely grown since then. One of the miniatures that they produced for that Kickstarter, though, is this Alexander miniature that you see before you. Now, I have to admit, I was a little hesitant to feature a second vampiric miniature when I had already featured one earlier in this year's Monster Fest in an episode of Mini of the Week. However, this is such a cool, amazing-looking miniature with a lot of character, I just couldn't help but do it again. I love, love, love the elegance of this miniature. Generally speaking, when you see a vampiric miniature, for the most part, they're very open, especially if you get into like the Games Workshop models, for instance. The Reaper miniatures, the older sculpts like you saw with Van Storm, have an elegance and a charm to them, but a lot of the more modern sculpts, especially from any manufacturer really, have a more violent sculpt to them. The miniatures are more open, they're more aggressive in their appearance. But here we have something in Alexander that is very simplistic. We have a vampire that is very obviously in a court somewhere, in the middle of a bow towards one of his brethren or some higher up somewhere. He might not even be in a vampiric court. But it's so interesting. He's sort of holding this cloak in front of his face and bowing, and he's holding his other cloak out to the side in this very elegant manner. But then as you look at it, you begin to realize that his cloak is not actually a cloak. It's actually the wings of his bat form that he's halfway transformed into. And that he's not actually holding his cloak out to the side. Those are really his fingers that are extended all the way, these bony, lengthy fingers, all the way to the end of the cloak. And that he's got his other part of his bat wing on his right hand wrapped around the front of his body. It's so amazingly well done. It's just a beautiful figure with so much elegance and whimsy and character to it that I had to feature it in this episode of Mini of the Week. I will say that the only thing that detracts from this miniature, and it may simply be because what you're looking at is the same thing that I'm looking at, which is a 3D rendering of the miniature in very large scale form. The only thing that I find detracting is the wing itself, the one that's outstretched on the left side of the model. And the only reason that I find it a little detracting is that the way that it's sculpted, it almost looks like he's holding out a gigantic slice of Swiss cheese. Now, I'm hopeful that the actual miniature itself, scaled down to a much smaller scale and fully painted up with the appropriate colors, would take away this idea that he's holding a slice of Swiss cheese out to his side. But to me, that's kind of what it looks like, and it makes it almost a little bit humorous in its appearance. If you didn't check it out, though, check out the face of this model. The face of it is very, very cool. You have almost, it's not necessarily a like a classic vampire. The face of this model is more a modern type vampire sculpt, where it's a more horrific appearance. It doesn't have that I don't want to say the word elegance again, but what am I looking for? There's a certain charm to the old school, like the Bela Lugosi vampires from, you know, the original Dracula film. There's a royal sort of appearance to that style vampire that has been copied over and over and over again throughout the years. But in this particular model, you have a much more horrific vampire style look, something you might, for instance, see in maybe one of the Underworld movies. But in this particular instance, the face of this model, he's not necessarily fully transformed into his vampire form. He still has some somewhat humanoid features, but you can tell that his face is in the middle of shifting into this much more monstrous appearance, whether he's, like I said, almost halfway between his humanesque form and his bat form. It is a very animalistic appearance to his facial structure and just the way that it's sculpted. The whole model is absolutely gorgeous. It's got so many cool features to it, and it's just overall an absolutely beautiful mini, and I hope that you will check it out because it is just an amazing, amazing model. Again, it's manufactured by Gribo Games. The model is called Alexander, and it currently retails for €7.99, which translates to roughly about $9.50 right now with the current exchange rate. So it's not that expensive of miniature. Now, you are going to have to pay shipping all the way from Italy, but overall, you're probably looking at less than $17, $18 to pick this model up. So very, very, very inexpensive and a great looking miniature to boot. And that, my friends, is what makes Alexander this week's Mini of the Week. I hope that you have enjoyed this episode of Mini of the Week. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave those in the comment section down below. Also, be sure to leave a thumbs up on this video and subscribe to AG Productions so that you get notified every single time a new video gets posted. Also, be sure to support me on Patreon. Every little bit helps to create greater quantity of videos and better quality videos, and I appreciate every cent that comes my way. Thank you once again for watching. I really, really do appreciate it. God bless you all. Have an amazing rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.